Toronto opened a new vaccine clinic at the Metro Toronto Convention Center Monday in preparation for mass immunization in the city. But then the clinic will have to close again after Friday.
We were all disappointed to learn that the delivery of Pfizer vaccine to Canada is expected to be delayed as a result of manufacturing delays in Europe.
Alberta said about 90,000 vaccines have already been given to high-priority groups in the province, but because they don't have any more vaccines in storage, Premier Jason Kenney said they won't be able to schedule new appointments for first doses until further notice.
It's doubly disappointing that Pfizer has since been able to readjust its delivery schedule so that European countries will not be significantly affected, but Canada's supply will be held back.
In BC, top doctor Bonnie Henry said there will also be a slow delivery of vaccines because of Pfizer's delay. But she assured that the province will try to catch up when extra doses come in by the end of February to early March. The delay in Pfizer's vaccine delivery comes at a time when new COVID-19 infections in Canada has already surpassed 700,000, with deaths of over 18,000. Public Health Canada Chief Dr. Theresa Tam stressed it's time for Canadians to double down, as new forecasts warn that if restrictions are lifted too soon, infections in Canada may climb up to 10,000 weekly until the end of the month. Meanwhile, BC Premier John Horgan is seriously looking into an interprovincial travel ban to keep BC in a safe bubble. Filipino Canadians are among those who said they are in favor of the travel ban.
Mas maganda po yung control po yung dito sa BC po.
That's the very least that we citizens can do.
I feel like it's for the safety of everybody. And then later on, maybe we can, let's see how long it's gonna last.
Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News.